Hello, it is your friendly neighbourhood maths teacher back again, here to give you a quick maths lesson about quadratics, or double brackets is how you may know them. I'm going to explain to you what on earth this means, how we see it in maths exams, and how we can complete those questions and get the marks. So a little bit of a recap first of all. Before, in algebra, we've looked at expanding brackets, things that look like this perhaps, okay? 3 open brackets, 2x plus 6. If I asked you to expand that bracket, what would you have to do? You'd have to multiply everything inside the bracket by 3 separately. Okay, so we could draw these two little lines here, and we do this multiplication, and we do this multiplication. So what would 3 times 2x be? That would be 6x. 3 times 6 would be 18. So our answer would be 6x plus 18. And remember, we don't combine those together. Okay, it's like you're saying, I have 6 xylophones and 18 pounds. You can't combine those two things together, they are separate. Okay, so that is how we would expand a single bracket. Sometimes in maths, we need to expand double brackets that look like this. Okay, x plus 3 in a bracket, x plus 5 in a bracket. Now, if you've got two things in algebra with nothing between them, what does that mean? It means they're being multiplied together. There's an invisible times here in the middle. Okay? There are 3 methods we can use to expand double brackets, and I'm going to show them to you now. The first method, very simple, grid method multiplication, okay? So I have to multiply x plus 3 by x plus 5. I'm going to put that all into a grid, like this, okay? X plus 3, x plus 5. I've put it all into a grid method, and this is a multiplication grid, so I'm just going to times it all out. What is x times x? Have a think, be very careful. It's not 2x, it's x squared, okay? What is x times positive 3? It's just 3x, okay? Similar idea, what's positive 5 times x? It's just 5x. What is positive 3 times positive 5? It is positive 15, okay? Then I need to add all of those things together. X squared is by itself. 3x and 5x, can we combine those? Yes, we can. We get what? 8x, very good. And then 15, again, is by itself. So our answer is going to look like this. X squared plus 8x plus 15. And this is what we call our quadratic equation. Okay, they always look like this. X squared, x, and a number on the end. Okay, that's how we recognize them. And that's what we get when we expand double brackets. Here is another method you can use if you're not vibing with the grid method. This is called the lobster claw. You might have seen this before. Same brackets. And all I'm going to do is draw a line between the x's, a line going to the 5, a little line there, and another line there. And it kind of looks like a lobster claw around the brackets, if you can see that. Okay? And then, similar to how we did with the single bracket multiplication, we're just going to times everything that's connected by a line together. X times x gives me x squared. X times 5 gives me 5x. X times 3 gives me 3x. And 3 times 5 gives me 15. And then, same as we did in the last one, we're just going to add all of those terms together. So x squared plus 5x plus 3x plus 15, but we can combine these to get 8x. So that is the same answer we got the last time. X squared plus 8x plus 15. Another way of thinking about it, and this is the way that I did when I was doing my GCSE maths, the FOIL method. FOIL stands for first, outer, inner, last. And that's basically how we draw the lobster claw, okay? It's saying the same thing. So first means you're connecting the first two, you're timesing those together. Outer, you're connecting the outer ones. Inner, you're connecting the two inner numbers. And the last, you're connecting the last ones in each bracket, okay? So the first in each bracket, the outers, the inners, and then the last in each bracket. And then we times them together. So the first ones, x times x, is x squared. The outers, x times 5, is 5x. The inners, 3 times x, is 3x, and the last, 3 times 5, is 15. Again, we add it all together, we get the same answer, x squared plus 8x plus 15. Those are the 3 methods you can use. If you want to pause now and practice some of those on expanding double brackets, then you are welcome to. I want to show you one more variation on this, because sometimes we will have negative numbers in our brackets. So if you had an example that looks like this, a couple of things have changed here. 2x plus 4, x minus 3. We've got a number in front of x, and we've got a negative. This can happen, but the method stays the same. So I'm going to use the grid method here, because I think it's probably the easiest if you haven't done this before. There's our grid. 2x plus 4, x minus 3. So don't think of this as x take away something. Think of this as a negative 3. And so I've drawn it in here as negative 3. And we're just going to times into the grid there. So 2x times x gives me what? So that's already 2 times x times x. So we've got two x's there and a 2. It is 2x squared. Okay? X times positive 4, 4x. 2x times minus 3. What's 2 times minus 3? Minus 6. So it's just minus 6x. Okay? And then 4 times minus 3, minus 12. When we add all that together, we'll get 2x squared on the front. 4x minus 6x. What's 4 minus 6? It's minus 2. Okay? And then minus 12 on the end. So 2x squared minus 2x minus 12. Okay? The other thing that we have to do when we're dealing with quadratic equations is sometimes we will be asked to take this equation and put it back into double brackets, which is also called factorizing. Well done if you remembered. So I'm going to show you how to factorize. If we look back at our first equation that we had, x plus 3x plus 5, when you look at this plus 8 that we ended up with down here, where does 8 come from? Well, it came from adding the 3 and the 5. In other words, that 3 and that 5. They add together to make 8. Where does 15 come from? They times together to make 15. So when we're taking this and putting it back into double brackets, you need to look for a pair of numbers to go with your x's, and they need to add to make the middle number, and they need to times to make the end number. Let me show you what that means. So if I take the same quadratic equation here, I know I'm looking for two numbers that add to make 8 and times to make 15. Okay, so let's list them out. What adds to make 8? 1 and 7, 2 and 6, 3 and 5, 4 and 4. What times is to make 15? Not as many options. You could have 1 and 15 or 3 and 5. And then all I need to do is see which numbers are in both lists. Which pair of numbers do I see twice? It's this one. 3 and 5, 3 and 5. So those are my numbers. They're both positive, so it's x plus 3, x plus 5. Okay, that is all we have to do. Let's have a look at another example here. X squared plus 7x plus 12. Where did I say this 7 came from? Adding. Okay, where did I say this 12 came from? Timesing. So I'm looking for two numbers that add to make 7 and that times to make 12. Have a think, see if you can work it out. So what adds to make 7? 1 and 6, 2 and 5, 3 and 4. What times is to make 12? 1 and 12, 2 and 6, 3 and 4. Which number do I see twice there? 3 and 4. Okay, so those are my answers. Again, they're both positive, so it's x plus 3, x plus 4. So that factorized is that. Okay, that's all we have to do. So the very last thing we might have to do with quadratic equations is sometimes we might have to factorize a quadratic equation that has negatives in it. The method is exactly the same, do not panic. Okay, so it might look like this: x squared minus 4x minus 5. Again, I'm looking for two numbers that add to make minus 4 and that times to make minus 5. Remember, these minuses are part of that number. Okay, so they need to add to make minus 4 and times to make minus 5. I'm not going to list all the numbers that add to make minus 4 because I could be here forever. I'm going to think about this. What times is to make minus 5? I could say 1 times minus 5, or the opposite of that. Minus 1 times 5. Okay, so those are my options. Which of these, when you add them together to each other, is going to give me minus 4? Will that give me minus 4? Or will that give me minus 4? It's this one, okay? Minus 5 plus 1 gives me minus 4. So that's what goes in my brackets, okay? X plus 1, x minus 5. And that is all you have to do to factorize this quadratic. Have a go, have a practice at some of those. Feel free to watch back through this video, take some notes, work out whatever you need to. Let me know if you have any questions, and thank you for watching this video.